the definition of scalar multiplication. You know, let's try and break down a little bit what that textbook says to us. If matrix A is, again with these square brackets, A sub I, J, again this lowercase letter A is just identifying all of the elements that are in matrix A by what row and by what column it is in. So if A is a matrix of order MN and C is a scalar, now there's no notation of C being a certain order or size matrix because that is just going to be a real number that gets multiplied through and applied to each of the elements in our matrix. Getting ahead of myself. Then the matrix CA, now notice this is a lowercase c, indicating that we're talking about a scalar multiple of matrix A, is another matrix M by N. Now see, we're starting off with a matrix of order MN, M by N, and we're getting another matrix of order M by N. So the number of rows, the number of columns are not going to change. And that's given by C times A, if you will, is given by C times lowercase a of A sub J, I sub J. What? Okay. So C is a real number. It's a scalar multiple. It's getting multiplied to matrix A. And now we have CA. Oh, yeah, that's right. When you have two variables touching in algebra, that means multiplication. So really, this is fancy math language for multiply each element, you know, by C. So it won't be too difficult, the work involved with the scalar multiplication. Just want to run through a couple of examples and make sure you have the process down before you get on to doing your homework. The wife is on the way home. She was on the phone. Okay, so we're going to have, with these two matrices, what is 2B? Can we apply the scalar multiple of 2 to matrix B? Well, yeah, I just said multiply all the elements by C, and I can certainly multiply by 2. So 2B is going to be equal to, well, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. 2 times positive 2 is going to be positive 4. We have 2 times positive 1, which is 2. 2 times negative 3, which is negative 6. 2 times 6, which is positive 12, and then finally 2 times 0 is going to be equal to 0. And now we're going to listen to the dog bark a little bit and do 2b minus 3a. Well, I just wanted to save myself a little bit of work there on the fact that I've already figured out what 2b is equal to. So we're going to have that negative 2, negative 6, 4, 12, 2, and 0. Now we're going to do 2b minus 3 times a. Now you have a choice here. You can either write minus and then set up your new matrix, 3a matrix, by applying the scalar multiple of 3 through each of these elements. But now, like in the previous board when we were adding and subtracting matrices, you have to remember to check that negative as you go to each of those terms in this second matrix. I think it'd be easier if we do sort of like a plus negative. I hate writing this in algebra, but I do think this is a good point to say, well, let's do 2b plus negative 3a and apply that scalar multiple of negative 3 through matrix A, and then I don't have to worry about my signs so much as I go to combine these two new matrices. So negative 3 times 7 is negative 21. Negative 3 times 1 is negative 3. Negative 3 times negative 3 is positive 9. Negative 3 and negative 2 is 6. And then we have 0. And then we have negative 15. Okay, well now we have a 2 by 3 matrix. So 2 rows and 3 matrix, adding 2 matrices of the same order is a piece of cake. Negative 2 plus negative 21, when you're combining numbers with the same sign, you want to add those and keep the sign. So we have negative 23. 4 plus negative 3 is equal to 1. 2 plus 9 is 11. Negative 6 plus 6 is going to be 0. 12 plus 0 is going to be 12, of course. And then 0 plus negative 15 is negative 15. And that is, again, another example of adding matrices of the same order. And, you know, how do you apply a scalar multiple? Which we're really pretty much done with. I'm just going to give you the properties of scalar multiples and work through another example before getting on to how to multiply matrices. Alrighty, Here are the properties, those properties of scalar multiplication. We're going to use a little bit of them to solve this equation involving matrices. If A and B are M by N matrices, so they're the same order or same size, and C and D are scalars, then the following properties are true. We have this first property, which is the associative property, if I could talk right, C and D. We can multiply those two scalars together and then apply them to matrix A, or you can regroup those parentheses and maybe apply one of the two scalars to matrix A and then go back and apply the other scalar if there's for some reason you would like to do that. 1 times matrix A is still going to be matrix A, so multiplying by a scalar of 1, just like in regular multiplication, it's sort of an identity multiplication. We have the scalar multiple being applied to two matrices being added together. Well, you can apply that scalar multiple to each of those matrices individually, or if you have two scalars being added and then that being applied to a matrix A, then you can maybe write your notes correctly and distribute the matrix A through the adding of those two scalars. And both of those are examples of the distributive property. Now, on our next example, we have again those matrices of A, which is 7, 1, negative 3, negative 2, 0, and 5, and matrix B, negative 1, negative 2, 1, negative 3, 6, and 0. Again, those orders are 2 by 3, the same matrices we had in the previous window. And we're going to solve this equation, you know, the matrix of 2A minus some other matrix, matrix X, is going to be equal to the matrix, what we get when we take the scalar of 3 and apply it to matrix B. We're going to solve for X. And solving this equation is very, very similar in the beginning to just solving a two-step equation you learned in Algebra 1. We're going to isolate the X. So we're going to move this term of 2A, or 2 scalar multiple of 2 applied to matrix A, but just think of it as 2A. We're going to subtract that from both sides of the equation, because if you look to the left of this, there's no plus or minus. They're indicated, so we can assume that's a plus 2A and get negative X is equal to 3B minus 2A. Just handle this like you're dealing with like terms in Algebra 1. We're going to finish isolating this X by dividing that term and all of the terms on both sides of the equation by negative 1. And, you know, of course, because there's an assumed to be negative 1 there, and we're trying to undo that multiplication of negative 1. And we get X, except I'm writing A, we get X is equal to, now I'm going to turn this around just to have the, I don't know why, just to have the positive term first. Negative 2 divided by negative 1 is equal to positive 2A, and 3 divided by negative 1 is negative 3. So we have 2A minus 3B. Okay, so matrix X is what you get when you take the scalar multiple of 2 and apply it to matrix A. So we're going to have 2 times each one of these. So we're going to have 14, 2, and negative 6. And negative 4, 0, and 10. And again, instead of doing a scalar multiple of 3 through here and then having to write minus and then distribute that negative as I go through the subtraction process with these matrices, I'm going to put a plus and think of that as 2a plus negative 3b, and that is going to be negative 3 going through each of these, so positive 3, negative 6, negative 3. And again, taking that negative 3 through the bottom row, we have 9, negative 18, and 0. I'm taking my time, you know, not just because I'm doing a lesson, I'm trying not to make a mistake, but it is very, very easy to make a small arithmetic error with matrices, do a whole bunch of work, and then get to the final answer, you know, and of course it'd be wrong. And because you've done so much basic arithmetic, it's hard to find that mistake. Almost better to just crumple up the paper and start over again. 14 plus 3 is equal to 17. 2 plus negative 6 is negative 4. And negative 6 plus negative 3 is negative 9. We have negative 4 and 9 is equal to 5. 0 and negative 18 is negative 18. And then we have 10 plus 0 is equal to 10. And normally I like to try and shoot my lessons with the air off, but we're getting to the middle of summer, so it just has to be on. I hope it's not too distracting with the audio of this video, and now my neighbor is blowing his yard, so hopefully it's not picking that up too much with my microphone. And that is our answer. Let me just make sure I have not made a mistake. Okay, now let's get on to multiplying matrices.